वंदेहं श्रीगुरु।
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, fifth chapter, text number 33, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 14th of August, 1974, in Vrindavan, India.
आमयो जस्य भूतानां जायते जेन शुभ्रतः तदेव श्यामयं द्रव्यं न पुनाति चिकित्सितम्। इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्स। एक्चुअली दिस इज द एसेंस ऑफ कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस मूवमेंट। पीपल बिकम डिजीज बाय सेंस गैटिफिकेशन। एवरीवन नोज too much sense gratification means creating disease. For example, some nice eatable, because it is very nice rasgulla, therefore I shall devour one dozen. That's not very good. That will create indigestion immediately. So, in this material world, people are so much enthusiastic in the matter of sense gratification. Whole world. Not only now, this is the place for competition of sense gratification. Advancement of civilization means the so-called civilization. Means how much you are able to gratify your senses, that is civilization. How much you are given facilities to gratify your senses. This is the modern idea, hedonism. More eat, more drink, eat, drink, be merry and enjoy. Sense gratification. This is not only new, formerly the Charvak Muni, he also advocated, Rinam Kritya Kritam Privet. In India, they want to eat very nice foodstuff prepared from ghee. So he advised, the Rinam Kritya Kritam Privet. If you have no money, then beg, borrow, steal, get ghee and eat very nice. Rinam Kritya, the word is, suppose one has no money, then how to get money? Either cheat somebody or beg, but begging for Grihastha is not very good thing, but sometimes they do so. They beg, borrow, or promise him, give me now money, I shall pay you. And when a credit is lost, then steal, pickpocket. This is as theory. Similarly, Charvak Muni, Rinam Kritya Kritam Privet. Never mind. Now I'll have to pay. Now, that we shall see later on. Never mind. Now I will be sinful, I will have to pay next life. This is within the blood of every Indian, that if I cheat you or if I take some money from you without your benefit, without repayment, then I will have to suffer. Still, in India they believe this. There are some incidences that a man's father took some loan from some gentleman, and his father died, and his son came to pay the money to the creditor. Sir, my father took so much money from you, Now my father died without payment, so I have got money, you kindly take it. He says, let me see my book, whether your father took it. So he said, all right, consult. So after consulting the books, he said, I don't find any item that I gave loan to your father. No, sir, I know my father said at the time of death that I owe so much money to that gentleman, I could not pay, you pay it. So the trouble was, the man says, I don't find any debit to your father's name, how can I take your money? And he is insisting, yes, my father took money from you, kindly take. This was India. They knew that I cannot cheat you. For me, in the karmakanda, if I cheat you, then I will have to pay you four times, this life or next life. That is the law of karma. Therefore, we are collecting money. We should not cheat. Every pie should be spent for Krishna, otherwise we shall be liable to pay. If we use one farthing for our sense gratification, then we'll have to pay for it. This is the law of karma. The charity is given. Why? Why charity is given to the Brahman? Nowadays they have manufactured charity to the Daridra Narayan, poor man, ganja smoker, biri smoker. But in the Shastra, it is not. Shastra says, Tasmin Deya, those are devotee, those are Brahmana, they should be given, he should be given, he should accept. Why? Because if a Brahmana takes some money from you, if a Vaishnava takes money from you, everything will employ in the service of the Lord. This is the philosophy. So, at the present moment, people are becoming more and more poor, and they are simply educated to gratify senses.